there, and welcome to Actoroki Season 5. Tonight we, just right before we came on and something happened. But tonight, once again, we're coming to you live from the Chaldea Studios in beautiful downtown. Where are we? Is it Duwamish?
Downtown Duwamish.
We're Tequila?
By Duwamish.
We are by the Duwamish.
East-West Seattle's good.
Below West Seattle somewhere is where we're at.
It's the base of Pigeon Hill.
Is it really called Pigeon Hill?
It is Pigeon Hill.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Okay. I wonder how many pigeons are there.
You learned something new every day. Anyway.
I thought it's where they stood at the top and they threw things. You know, they're pitching it.
It's not Pigeon Hill. It's
like
Pigeon.
Throwing things down.
Oh, man. Okay, it's going to be one of those nights again.
It's always one of those nights.
I'm Mike Boozer, as you don't know or do know. I'm the game master for Actoroki. I can be found, at Gen Con. I work for Gen Con, and badge registration's coming up on February 11th for Gen Con. So go get a badge and go to the show and
find him there.
And you can find me.
You
can find me at Gen Con. Yeah. Good luck. It's like, where's Waldo? It's where's Mike?
I'm wearing a striped shirt.
I'm all over the place. Anyway,
done.
That's enough about me. I'm going to go to my left let Rich introduce himself.
Oh, hi. Pardon me.
Oh.
Okay. So, hi. My name is Rich. Hi. My name is Rich Kalis. I identify as he, him. You can find me at The Kalis on Instagram. Not that it's very exciting, but I'm trying to make it more exciting.
Okay.
Yeah. I play Foley, a blazing red-haired, handsome, quite often smiling, Shorter lad.
Hi there. I'm Rennie Recto, he, him. I play Archibald, also he, him, who is a warlock, incredibly charming, very charismatic, and incredibly smart and handsome, like you, Rich.
Wow.
Aww. No, Foley.
You can find me on Instagrams as Rennie Francis. Also, look for zombieorpheus.com on our Discord server. You'll find me there as well.
Hi, I am Danny. I use she, her pronouns, as so does my character, Clary. She is a druid halfling. You can find me on Instagram through Danny's eyes, or you can find me on the Gen Con social media accounts. We're doing some really fun stuff there now that Badge Reg is happening, so check us out.
Hey, I'm Bryce Bebop. I identify as he, they, as does Cass A. Nova, the wondrous death metal bard. You can find me on Instagram at Bebop Bryce. You could also just look up Bryce Bebop. Pretty much comes up wherever. That's pretty much what I got going on.
Is that what you got? Okay, so tonight we also, of course, have our wonderful artist, Tanelle, who will be doing some great sketches and drawings that we'll show you throughout the programming. Wow, programming. That was pretty amazing.
Special guest.
Which special guest? Oh, you mean that one?
Yeah.
That one?
The important one.
And then the special guest again tonight, joining us again because she's a good dog, is Maui. She heard her name. So she'll be here tonight as well, entertaining us with nothing. She doesn't do much.
Papa, looking
for a handout, Maui. So, jumping right into it, we left you all in the cabin in the woods. Cozy little cabin.
Cozy cabin in the woods.
Nice and cozy.
That's a nice cabin.
Snow is falling outside the cabin, and it is actually starting to really come down. Winds, blizzard. You can hear the howling through the windows, and it's really quite the storm out there. So visibility is zero. You can't really see anything, but the cabin is cozy and warm. Big fire in the fireplace, a big, huge fireplace, big fire in there that you guys started the fire.
Yep.
It's up, so there you go.
There are windows.
There are windows that look out. They have curtains. It's all very nice, kind of
bedrooms.
Thomas Kincaid.
No bedrooms. It's a one bedroom place.
So it's a one room.
Yeah, and it's got this. It's got a couple beds on the sides, on either side. It's a studio. It's a studio.
There are windows
cabin.
On every wall.
There are windows. No, there's windows on three of the walls. There's a front window that looks out more of a picture window, a little bigger than two side windows. And of course, in the back, the fireplace dominates the back wall. Right. It is kind of spacious. I mean, it feels there's lots of room to walk around. Big table, sofa, chairs by the fireplace. Also, a table off to the side for eating. You know, like a table like this size. And then there's a couple beds off as well to the sides.
You know, I'm just wondering, it's sort of strange, it's nice and comfortable and warm in here, like as if it was being prepared. Mm-hmm. I wonder if there was somebody here, maybe there's like a secret entrance or exit in this room. Anybody here really good at looking for that type of thing?
Yes, I am.
Anybody else?
Dang.
Oh, ouch.
Sort of.
Well, I'll tell you what.
But I think Cass would be much better than me, so go ahead, Cass.
I get that a lot. But not just from you. No, there's nothing wrong with both of us doing some
okay,
of this searching.
Go ahead.
Inspiration.
perception, right?
Yep.
19.
So you're looking around. You don't see any other entrances or exits besides the front door here. You don't see anything looking around. You do notice there are some rather nice, large, comfy rugs underneath the table and the sofa.
On the ground.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, large rugs.
Should we check underneath the rugs?
If I was going to put a secret trap door, I'd probably put it on the floor under a rug.
This is why you guys are smarter than I am.
So. I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
Yeah, I want, can you say it into this microphone?
Maybe write it down.
This is why you guys don't understand sarcasm.
So I'll go to the, without moving anything,
yeah.
I'll go to one of the rugs and just kind of lift it up and have Cass look underneath.
All right. Which one?
Are they pretty?
Which one?
You said there were two.
There's one underneath the table, the kitchen kind of table, and there's one underneath the sofa, love seat.
Check the sofa first.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Under the sofa. Mm-hmm. But I don't want to move furniture.
Okay.
So I figure if there's a hatch, it's going to be taking up a good portion of under the rug. Does that make sense? I just don't want to move stuff.
I mean, I'm fine with moving
stuff.
So
you look underneath, you do not see a... you do not see any secret door.
Okay.
However, you do see something. Underneath there, it seems to be a pentagram, like a circle pentagram, circle with a pentagram in it, kind of thing.
Oh, good.
Not looking. It. Oh, I mean.
I told you there was something
some
off about
runes
this.
Runes on that, and
what are the runes?
It's hard to see with the carpet.
Let's look under the table.
Agreed.
So we'll go to the one at the table.
All right.
I lift it up.
There's nothing there. I don't see. It's all floorboards.
Archibald, can you move this couch? You are much stronger than either of us, so.
Oh, really? I am more strong than the two of you?
Well, that's how sarcasm works, right? I was trying to understand it.
Back to the sarcasm. I love it.
It's like, I think that I think two people working together might actually be better. Like you did with looking for the carpets and looking for things.
So you're inviting Claire to help you move the couch? That's
nice.
Very sweet.
Sure. Like I'm small.
Wait.
But I
like
am mighty.
Really like, super, super tiny?
I just thought you were in being friendly.
First of all, really.
Yeah.
Was I wrong?
No.
Clary, are you comfortable moving this couch?
No, together.
Not by myself.
Yeah, with you.
You like, just said it would be good for people to work together to do these things.
Teamwork.
Like, look, it'll squish her. I mean, this is a big couch.
this is a mighty Clary.
You're rude.
It is rather large like a couch for a halfling to move.
Could do that.
Oh, yeah. That
seems like a lot.
I think it's probably just better, I guess, if we take this for him. Or either.
We could all do it together.
All
the couch
one
together.
Corner, teamwork.
All right.
We each take it. We each put it. Grab a corner.
Yep.
Go to the couch. I'm not helping a whole lot because I'm small.
Yeah. And you lift.
So it tips over.
That's true. One corner if you put us at opposite sides, then we're not doing a whole lot of work. Yeah. Yes. It's so heavy.
My biggest fear is a whole night will be spent moving furniture.
That's your biggest fear?
No. All right.
We rearranged the table.
We're going to rearrange the cabin.
We decided to redecorate the cabin tonight.
That's all we're going to do. To the left.
I roll for feng shui.
Go.
Move it to the right.
All right. So you move the couch out off of the carpet.
Roll the carpet out.
And now you've got chairs on it as well. And a little coffee table.
We move the chairs.
We move everything.
We're gonna scooch all of it away.
Yeah. And you're gonna.
We start rolling up the rug, but we don't full. I don't think. Well, I should just ask. I don't think we should fully expose the pentagram.
Why do you feel that way?
You tell me.
Well, you're the smart one. I see the glasses.
Everyone, stand back.
You ready? You ready? Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I figured if we roll it partially, then you can start looking at it and doing that hand-waving thing you do.
Yes. Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, totally.
It looks like runes, right, as we roll it back?
Yeah, does it look just like...
Runes, no
eye. I see anything in particular?
Yeah, I mean, there's some writing, and yeah, it looks pretty... It's pretty complicated, but... So you're going to roll it?
Partially.
I could just get in the center of it. It'll be fine.
What could go wrong?
I don't think anything could.
So you roll the carpet back?
Yeah.
Are we rolling it all the way?
I'd say mostly. We reveal just the edge of the runes, or to the point where there's a little bit of runes. We're like, nope, right there.
Whatever our warlock thinks is best.
True.
That's fair.
Weigh in, please.
Yeah, so
you are the strongest one.
I'll do the cast. I will do... It's true.
I wouldn't lie about that.
I'm gonna do a knowledge.
Wow.
Knowledge what?
Apparently, we are the smartest.
We are.
Wow.
Knowledge of dealing with pentagrams.
Arcana, maybe.
Yes.
All right.
Which should be I rolled a 7, totally. A 3 plus a 4.
I want to roll.
All right.
I just want to roll just to see if I get more than.
Oh, snap.
19.
Ooh. I'm happy for you, Clary.
Anyone else?
I rolled a 19.
Knowledge of Canna?
Sure, why not? I got less than Archie.
Oh. All right.
I'm a 19. So smart.
So the druid goes, hey, these are kind of like, this like is a like a summoning circle. Something would be summoned from here, or it would, you'd summon something,
Don't ask how I know it. It looks
like a summoning circle.
There were some mushrooms in this old temple one time, and I went there to get some, and it kind of looks similar to that.
Yeah.
Were they summoned mushrooms?
No, I don't know what they did there, but the mushrooms were off in the corner. It looked the same.
So,
I wonder what it could summon. Can you read these runes?
Can I?
No.
No. I don't know what they are. Unfortunately.
I believe I'm still really tired.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, maybe tomorrow I could read them.
All right, let's do some sleepy times.
Let me...
Okay, all right.
I want to touch it.
I was going to try an investigation on it.
Okay, on the circle?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
13.
I mean, it's not really, really big, so it's whatever could be summoned has to be probably not too large. That's kind of what you get. You know, it's about 6 feet, it's 6 foot in...
That's really big.
Walrus?
I would love that.
A walrus summoning circle in the middle of a cabin? Yeah.
Okay. I like to think about what's the worst thing it could summon. And in my head, Spitzfire shows up. So
I can see Spitz, though, so.
Yeah. But he'd still be the worst to appear.
Who's Spitz?
He's this little jerk sorry, they're this little jerk of an imp who gives us jobs sometimes, but also is mostly just an information broker.
Also, they can't see him, but I can.
He can. Yeah. They can turn invisible.
That's fair.
I'm going to touch the circle.
Okay.
I back up.
You touch the circle?
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing happens.
Okay, guys.
Do we want to recover it and then rest?
Yeah, probably. we should rest before we reveal
it. So cozy
it
in here.
Everyone do a perception check.
Great.
I can do that.
16.
A three.
What's a perception?
17.
Wow. You're not. It's not your night, Warlock.
I'm doing great. Yeah, 17. 17.
What'd you get?
This die is very good.
16,
tonight.
17.
Eight. Me and Reddy.
You two notice there's something. That fire is kind of acting strangely.
You see that?
Oh, I see that.
Yeah. And then pretty soon you see two eyes blink open in the middle of it.
I see two eyes?
Yeah, both of you do.
Oh, nice.
No, just you.
Just
sorry.
Me. Is it Spitz?
It looks like it. He looks like he's probably in that fire somewhere. Yeah.
Spitz
eyes. It's got Spitz eyes.
Is this the fire?
It's like it's got Betty Davis eyes and it's got Spitz eyes. For you at home, that's an old song. I'm not sure that any of you get the reference, but anyway.
Spitz is here.
Yeah.
Lovely.
He's Spitz. In the fire.
And he's looking at Clary. He's looking at you and going, oh, hi.
Spitz is here.
Not dealing with it. Nose goes.
Hi, Spitz.
Cool.
Hi! How are you?
Great. How are you?
Warm.
Yeah, I would think so. You're in the fire.
Yep.
What are you doing here?
Just nice place to, you know, it's cold out. Yeah, I don't like cold.
Spitz, how'd you find us?
I just found the cabin in the woods and I went in.
Is it because we were talking about
it? I was here before you.
What?
I was here before you.
Well, why would you have come here?
Because it's warm and cozy.
I'm sure there's warmer places than here. What motivated you to come here?
Were
you called?
No.
Summoned?
No.
Following us?
He was following us from a distance because I hadn't seen him. So if he was following us, he's been keeping...
So how did you come through the portal after we did?
What portal?
All right. Have you been here before?
What?
To this cabin?
No. What makes you think that?
Well, I don't know. How did you find it? How do you know where it is?
This is happenstance.
Oh, uh-huh. Likely story.
Happenstance.
Perception.
No wonder you don't like to deal with Spitz.
Oh my God, I won.
God. You're
put that he's guy
on the roll.
Away.
The warlock's on the roll tonight.
That's like me last time.
Hey, Cass, how's it going?
Why?
That die goes to die.
What do you need from us, Spitz?
Maybe what it was. What do I need? What do you need from me?
What?
Nothing.
No, you do. You need help.
Are you hinting about something, Spitz?
Uh-huh.
Can I roll an?
Is it the other globe? Maybe he knows how to...
I want to pull you
in. Right into the fire.
Not literally.
No, no.
All right, Spitz.
I piqued your curiosity.
You haven't, but I'm really tired, and I don't think you're going to go away until you
Cass,
finish.
You should
show
sleep.
Him one of those globes.
Oh,
what
globes?
We don't have any globes.
Show him the globe.
Oh, dear.
I will be showing Spitzfire nothing. Clary, we don't reveal information to Spitz.
Ixnay on the Obey.
Obey? Wouldn't it be Obey?
Fine.
He's an information broker. We trade. Mm-hmm. That's how it works. I'll show you these cool magical items we got if you tell us what you're doing here to help us.
Well.
Truthfully.
Have I ever... can't say it. He just stops and goes,
lied?
Yeah, that's the word. Hey, I'm just here. You know, I've been helping you all the time. I helped you that one time with that thing.
Yep, totally.
With those guys that were the sword things and the bow thing. And I helped you before. I've helped you time and time again.
You've helped us. We've helped you. It's kind of a business arrangement. And in our cozy cabin, I didn't think we were going to have a vacation with you, Spitz. So thanks for joining us. What do you got, bud?
Well, I was hoping that maybe, you know, I could just tag along.
Tag along?
Whoa.
Why?
Because you're kind of going somewhere I want to go.
That's a big ask, my dude.
Well, I know, it's kind of like, yeah, but you know.
Do you remember how we were supposed to just go to the place, read some scrolls?
I mean, be really you guys are like.
Yeah, and now we got like a little imp following us. Remember how life was easier? So, look, Spitz.
Yeah.
You know, we really like you, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
we see it the same.
He kind of nods, like, gives you a little look.
How is it going to benefit us if we let you tag along without making your life difficult?
Whose life difficult?
I'm going to give you some information that I've gotten from a source that will help you in your endeavor. How about that?
Okay.
On this particular endeavor?
Yes, this particular endeavor.
And is it real?
Is the information real?
Yeah, legit.
Yeah, of course.
What endeavor do you think we're on, Spitz?
You're trying to find a temple.
Mm.
There's a lot of people trying to find that temple now. Someone who's not very friendly towards you is trying to find that temple.
Who's that?
It's your best friend.
Sebastian.
Spurn me once, Sebastian. So you are offering us some information, and in exchange, we just let you tag along. Why do you want to go to wherever it is that you think we're going?
It's a good place to get away from it all.
Well,
down in Kokomo.
Yeah.
So I've got.
There's supposed to be stuff there, some fun stuff, right? You're going to look for some stuff, right?
Maybe.
You're going to look for some. What are you? You're looking for something, though.
So if we went to a place that had stuff,
what are you looking for?
And you want some of the stuff. Are you proposing that you split the stuff that was there with us? Or is there a specific thing of the stuff that you want?
Well, I mean, I'm kind of looking around. Generally, in a general way. Looking
for something specific?
Not specific, just possible.
You know, Spitz, I met someone recently.
Yeah?
Name of Tim.
Tim?
Oh, yeah.
Someone who was very interested in
finding you. Yeah.
Oh, well, that's gratifying.
Yeah.
No?
Probably shouldn't be.
Why? Who was Tim?
It was scary.
Yeah.
I don't know, about 9 foot, huge.
Locked in a sarcophagus. Yeah.
Oh.
Was he a demon? I don't remember.
Devil, demon.
Oh, no, it definitely was a devil.
Oh.
That's right.
Yeah?
Very interesting.
Really
in your
looking for
that's
you, yeah.
Was he, is he still locked?
No, he's out and about.
Did you let him out?
Oh, yeah.
No, that's not good.
For who?
For you.
Right? No, seems okay for me.
Let us leave.
He's very thankful.
Yeah, in fact.
Very thankful. He owes us a favor.
Well, we should band together for strength.
You know, I was thinking about that, Spitz, and I feel like maybe you should spend more time with us.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's been a long time. Have you ever been a familiar?
Well, I'm slightly familiar with you.
Yeah.
Slightly.
But what about a binding contract in which you act on our behalf?
Mm.
And by our behalf, I mean one of our behalves. And share magical prowess.
Oh.
And maybe we'll help shield you from big demons named Tim.
Maybe.
Devil's named Tim. Sorry, I get them confused.
It's okay. It's fair.
Yeah.
I have a previous contract.
Insight.
Maybe sure. We can break that with that person.
That is a 27.
Dang.
That well, probably means he's bound or some to someone or something.
Okay, so he's not lying to us.
No, he doesn't seem to be. Well, okay. He seemed to mean, you can't. It's hard to tell, but he seems, I mean, it seems pretty, it's extremely plausible that an imp is bound to somebody else. Somebody.
So who?
That he's working, he's probably working for somebody, not, he's not a, it's probably true that he's not an independent contractor, you kind of think.
Who's got your leash, Spitz? Because I'd like to purchase it.
No, I can't. That's just, no. Can't say. That's sorry.
Rough.
That's just.
That's rough.
Yeah.
I guess you don't want to go with us then.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I do, but I can't tell you that.
Okay.
You know, this but I can help you.
This
is actually true.
Fair.
This is true. Spitz is, could very much not just morally be obligated, but it could be. Causing a very, bound. Very problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you can't become someone's familiar, but what about swearing a legally binding oath to assist us while you're accompanying us? And I know how you feel about those since.
Well, you know. I mean, I can certainly, like, yeah, I you know, I think, you know, we could make a deal.
Okay.
Yeah, let's make a deal.
Yeah.
Like, we've made deals in the past. Those have worked out for both of us.
This is going to be more binding.
What do you mean?
I don't know. We're going to have to talk. I mean, you're traveling with us, means we'll have to protect you, which means you have to do what we say in case it means that you'll be safe. If we say, get behind a column, otherwise you'll die, I need you to get behind the column. No questions asked.
Okay.
So, like, you'll be bound to do what someone of our group here says.
So, get behind column number one. Got it.
No.
You know, that could be a thing, but we'll see. I've never been to an underwater temple before. And you're a little hot, so I don't think underwater is a good place for you, really, huh?
Well, I'm gonna go underwater.
Oh, well, you said you wanted to come with us, and that's where we're going, so.
Is that part of your information? You know how to get us to there without going underwater?
I don't need to go underwater.
Oh. You don't need to? Why not?
Well, I mean, I can...
I got an in, he says.
Okay,
so you have an in where you don't have to go underwater?
Yeah, I got a way to get in.
Okay, cool. So we can go that way, so we don't have to go underwater.
Well, yeah...
Thank you, Spitz. Yeah,
Spitz.
Man, you said you're going to be helpful, and gosh darn it, you are.
Well, you can.
How is it? How exactly is it? We need to know, that way we can prepare ourselves.
Well, I mean, I think he can. I don't know that you can, or you can, or, oh, hi, I'm Spitz.
Hi, Spitz.
What's your name?
My name's Foley.
Hi, Foley. I'm Spitz.
I see that, and I hear that.
Yeah, I'm an imp.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Interesting. Mm-hmm.
I know these guys, we go way back.
Is he still standing in the fire?
Yeah.
Okay.
Way back.
Way back.
That's where the fun is.
Yep.
But more importantly, I can help you with that fortress.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
not our primary objective, but okay.
But we got. But you see, to get to the temple, we got to get to the fortress.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
And you know, I mean,
how does that work? What do you mean we have to get to the fortress before we can get to the temple?
Well, the thing that the place to go to get to the temple is in the fortress.
Okay.
Okay.
But you need something, and I think you've got it. And that's the thing.
Oh.
So I think you said, I think you've got what you need, but I think it's not working right now, right?
I have no clue.
So what do you
know
about currently what's going on in here with the cabin in the woods?
Oh, it's cozy.
It is. Whose cabin is this, Spitz?
Oh, some really powerful something.
With a summoning circle underneath the carpet.
Yeah, it's like,
what is that?
Maybe
summon?
They could just pop in anytime.
Maybe we can just.
He starts getting nervous. And like,
oh man!
You like that name? Spitz goes a little
Spitz
off.
Spitz nervous laughter.
little mania there.
Little mania.
Maniac.
Little mania.
Yeah, maybe. So it would be really bad if we revealed the circle so they could appear.
I would like to cover that up. But like, I mean, they probably,
can
I mean,
we,
I don't know.
Can we just break it?
Sure.
Knowledge or
character? Usually you could have just...
Wow.
What's your roll?
I rolled a 12 this time. But
it's better than,
yes,
you know.
Than the 2 and 3. So mm-hmm. I'm rolling 12.
I break it.
You, what is the impact?
What could go wrong? Go ahead, break it.
Well, if you break, I mean, you think, look, if you made a summoning circle for something and you spent a lot of time and money on it and someone came in and broke it, how
it's
would you feel?
It's probably not going to be a good idea.
That's what you think.
Let's be fair. They're already upset with us.
What are they going to do?
We are sleeping in. Somebody's been sleeping in my bed.
Don't eat the porridge.
Should be noted, we have not slept yet.
No, it's true.
I want to. So, okay, Spitz, you know whose cabin this is. You know that they could appear in, and you seem to be a little afraid of it. So
I think it's Tim's.
It could be Tim's.
But Tim's dead.
Tim's 9 feet
Tim's
tall.
Not dead.
Tim's gone.
Tim's, no. He's somewhere.
Tim left.
He's somewhere.
Does
I hope it's Tim.
Does this cabin look like it accommodated a 9 foot tall creature?
No.
So my thought is, it's just probably that demon princes.
What?
Wow, you guys hang with a rough crowd.
Dude,
I think I need to go home.
Demon prince?
I've
what
only
demon
been
prince?
With them for like a month. It's why I hope.
Wait, you know a demon prince?
No, the little strong. We're more like acquaintances.
Like, you.
We're, sorry, Mally distracted me. There you go, Mal. So he goes, no, you don't know a demon prince.
Whoa.
I'm just saying. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't mean to be
pretty accusatory there, bud.
Well, I was like, I mean, like, that's some heavy duty stuff.
I know.
But do you really know a demon prince, or are you just messing with me? You're messing with me, Cass.
It's a little of both. It's a little of both, I would say.
So we have a deal?
We have a...
Wait.
What is the deal?
Yeah.
Goes, I like where this is going.
What is the deal? He goes, what's the deal?
We have the deal. From what I'm understanding from the conversation,
yeah?
That you are going to assist us and impart information to help us in our greater goal, and you are going to go with us, and we are going to protect you to the best of our abilities during the time that you're being assistive to us.
Great. Greater goal? What's your greater goal?
Whoa, that's...
Would you like us to
that's
be...
That's none
like
of your concern.
To specify a time period, then?
Wow, I thought I was really good at this stuff. A little confused. A little. I'm thinking. Who let the gnome into the party?
He says. Who let the gnome in?
He's gonna go. He's gonna say.
I will do. What am I gonna do?
Well, let me call up all my uses of deduction
can
here
I,
and all
I,
my five.
Can I apply investigation to this, or does it have to be something like deception or?
No.
Bardic inspiration.
Can I do?
Because I like what you're doing.
Can I do like verbal sleight of hand? Does that
no,
work? Is
no. But
a thing?
How about you have what do you have there? Investigation.
Investigation. I have insight, but no plus.
What about performance?
No insight. It's more insight than. Okay. Sorry, it's insight. I mean, okay. This is a kind of an insight roll.
Four.
Anyone?
I will roll insight.
But yeah. I need some assistance here, but we're trying to come down to the deal.
You guys are trying to... Nice.
21.
All right.
That's
so,
the best one.
I mean, you think it's probably best to get him to, to agree to a certain set of conditions.
Okay.
Specific
agreed.
Conditions. Not
specific?
Specific.
Too nebulous.
And not too nebulous, because he's probably not going to agree to anything.
You're all weak.
But he might agree to something that's very, you know, I do this, you do this, and you do this.
Mm.
So Spitz will help us get into the fortress and to the location that we need to get to. And then, in return...
I have another thing he needs to do for us.
Which is?
He needs to learn about the demon prince or whoever is in charge of the fortress and report back to us about who they are and their goals.
To the best of his ability.
To the best of his
ability. Without putting himself in danger.
Without putting himself in danger.
Why are you looking after Spitz?
It has to be
something
he's willing to do.
He'll take.
Yeah.
It's his job to look after himself, too, right?
But we're structuring a deal that he'll take.
Yeah.
If we tell him to go gather information from a demon prince, I don't know about you, but if I was Spitz, I'd be like...
I'm pretty sure we also misheard. I think it's Prince Damon. Not a demon at all. Just a dude named Damon.
Small difference?
Yeah.
That's a huge difference, Cass.
Maybe.
Damon Prince? Prince Damon?
I don't know. We'll just have to let Spitz's look and figure it out.
But I like this. So yeah, those two things. Mm-hmm.
And oh, I believe...
Wait a sec. There's no demon. Prince? It's Damon? The prince named Damon?
I'm not sure. We were told by orcs and it could have been confused.
There's no demon there. It's freaking Sebastian.
Oh.
Sebastian's there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that makes sense now.
Yeah, that makes more sense. Okay, so then restructure
and
this
we don't deal. Like Sebastian.
Sebastian, I think, is
that right?
Evil.
Just covering that.
Flashback.
No, right.
No, flashback.
And
we don't like
him. And we wear pink on Mondays.
And Tuesdays.
I love you, Sebastian. Okay.
Oh, Sebastian, you hurt me.
Does someone want to give him a download on Sebastian?
No, I know who Sebastian is.
Okay, all right.
Generally. I mean, I know what I know. I know how they reacted when they were like, are you here for Sebastian? No, I'm not here for Sebastian. It's a little replay from last game. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. That's okay. Pretty good.
I'm still not working for Sebastian as far as you know.
So, something's fine. Okay. So we have to get us into the fortress. Find out more information on Sebastian, because I do believe that he has something going on.
Yeah.
As in, gods are having issues tracking him down. That's a whole different story, Spitz. On your side, we will not tell Tim that we saw you.
Yeah. That's...
For a period of how long?
That's
for a period
long.
Of, let's go with 2 weeks.
50,000 years?
No, definitely not. Definitely not. Two weeks.
2 weeks?
How about
I'm sorry,
until we're done?
2 weeks is like this.
How about there. Until we're done with the
destination? Task?
Because that way he's protected that period. He takes us or through.
Until we get back to Graver's Dig.
Yes.
Okay.
And once we get back to Graver's Dig.
Yeah. But you're not in contact with Tim now.
You don't know
he
that.
He told us how to contact
yep.
him.
Yep.
So.
I mean, he did.
Yeah, you're going to consort with a devil?
We're consorting with you!
What's the role from my DM?
Hey!
It's called bluffing.
No need to be mean.
Bluff the DM.
We're not being speciesist.
He goes,
I have
hey,
the
look,
notes.
Look, I'm just a little minor guy. I'm not even a, like, I'm not...
You're like a little minor devil, right?
So we consort with, yes.
We consort with devils all the time.
So evidently.
Tim apparently is not anything different, except for he doesn't like you.
You don't need to tell.
Tim was pretty nice.
Tim was chill.
He just
us.
Let us go.
Tim was nice because you let him out.
Exactly, and he owes us a favor.
Yep.
Listen.
Totally.
He's also looking for you.
If I keep
you.
Tim on my good side, then. Yeah.
So anyway.
Look, we won't
what
tell
can
Tim.
Go wrong?
You won't tell Tim for the period
until
of.
Until we get back to Graver's Dig.
No.
Don't let him make an offer.
Oh, okay.
No.
Counter.
He does do offers.
For the period of 100 years.
Nope.
That's too long.
Why?
Because we don't live that long.
Well, I do.
Rough.
That sucks.
I intend to be a. It's going to take me that long to.
Wizened old devil.
Up the chain.
Cool.
To be Tim level.
2 years?
2 years.
Two. That's a hard bargain. 2 to 100. Let's split the difference.
And go one? 1 year?
40, 80, 80, 46. Let's do math.
So 40.
90,
so
six, 40, 48, 48 years.
Mm.
How about 1 year?
Yeah.
Oh dang. Yeah.
No, you went the other way.
Yeah.
How about 6 months?
6 months.
Ooh. 6 months? I think that's a
I'll
long time.
I'll probably just call him now.
I think there's a
yeah, we might
I'm just gonna keep going down.
I'll just give him a call.
All right.
Honestly.
Wait, how'd you wasn't that we just like rub our fingers together and call we have to say his name. Like what happens?
Hold on,
if
I'll
I,
tell you.
I'm trying to remember.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
No, so, keep going.
So
I'll tell you how we get.
Tell Tim where you are. We'll show you the key that we have.
Okay. You have a key?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To do
we
what?
Have, we have a couple keys.
Oh, nice. There we go. The fireplace.
Awesome.
I love it.
Nice have it. Little spits in the
I
fire.
Stay there.
It is.
Nice. We are there.
It's
this is our house
nice.
Now.
Oh, look at the pentagram.
Yeah, the pentagram on the.
That's
nice.
Trick.
This is sneaking off the carpet.
Live. Let's hope that nothing happens with the pentagram.
That's great. Thanks, Tanel.
So, are we also allowing him to go with us to the temple?
If he wants to. He has to assist. He has to get us in.
He wants to go to the temple.
Yeah.
Yeah. But then I get my part.
Which is what?
I get something from the temple.
What?
Something that I choose.
Nope.
I won't choose the same thing that you're looking for.
Really?
Yeah, I promise. You're looking for some, I don't know what you're looking for
exactly.
Sure.
Exactly, yeah, so.
Well, you're not looking for what I'm looking for, because you don't know that it's there.
What is
yeah,
it?
Yeah, we do.
Looks right. <radical. laughs>
What is it?
You know, okay, like, let's step back.
let's reset, Spitz.
He goes, now, you know, I make a living out of this. I do it all the time. But you guys are, it's just so, it's like, it's always
market.
Difficult. You're always so difficult. So.
I don't feel difficult.
You're difficult.
Me neither.
I just try and do it with a smile.
Spitz, we can't promise you anything inside the temple.
You have to promise something.
I promise you, I will give you a magical item in the temple.
No. He says, I'm looking for a specific thing, and you're not looking for it.
Then as part of our negotiation,
as long as we know.
Go ahead.
No, please, after
no,
you.
No, after you.
You seem so charming.
I hype
you.
I'm just like sitting in the corner sketching in my book. Drawing mushrooms.
Pearls before swine?
We are also working with someone else who's looking for something, so we can't promise you anything specific.
Yes, but you know what you're looking for, and I know what I'm looking for. You tell me what you're looking for, I'll tell you what I'm looking for. We can help each other.
Isn't that what we're doing?
Yes, but I want the certain specific thing.
Wait. What if the thing that we're looking for, let's say it's the same thing. Well, we have to deliver it, but it doesn't mean that it needs to stay in that person's possession.
That's not a bad idea.
Once we've delivered it. So, let's just agree that if it's the thing that we're looking for is the same thing, that ultimately
we need to deliver it,
but we won't stop you from taking it later.
I'm very much on the verge of confusion.
I don't think you're looking for the same thing I'm looking for.
What are you looking for?
Well, you go
are
first.
You going to tell me what you're
yes,
looking
I'm
for?
Sure. I will tell you what we're looking for after you tell us.
Sure.
Will you?
First agreement right now.
I have no idea what it is, but yes.
Well, that's true. He doesn't know either what we're looking for.
By the Bardic Code, I promise to you.
What? No offense. I trust that more than Warlock Code.
Same, right?
That shall be removed.
I'm looking for the Wand of Hecate.
Cool.
Ooh, that's definitely not what we're looking for.
Yep.
But I don't know if I feel like we get, like promise you that.
I mean, we can if you find it there, then I'm not going to stop you, right?
I'm good.
Oh wait,
I mean, what are we looking for?
Oh, we're just there to get notes.
Yeah, we're just reading some scrolls.
Yeah.
Notes?
Yeah.
scrolls?
Yeah.
You didn't know that? I thought you knew everything.
Yeah, I thought we talked about that.
We're just reading scrolls.
Anyway, we're just there to like get some notes on stuff.
You gotta be kidding me.
No, that's it. That's it. And you know what's even funnier?
Goes,
no one else can write them.
He starts stamping.
So.
He goes, are you serious? Just some notes?
Yeah, man.
This is, he goes, don't you know where you're going? He says.
No.
That's
we're going to this temple.
He's like,
can I roll any sort of knowledge to know about?
I also need every other magic item in there.
Sorry, bud.
No.
That's a big deal.
Deal.
Want to know about the Wand of Hecate.
Roll.
Okay.
Bardic knowledge.
Not a thing in this system.
Oh, what do they have? What do they have then?
I get
3.5. Sorry,
I get half of
these
my,
at home. I'm 3.5 in it. What?
I have all skills.
Okay, all skills. So it's going to be knowledge. Knowledge Arcana or knowledge history.
Okay.
Or religion.
Okay.
They're all the same. Yeah.
So 18.
Well, if it's actually a wand that is connected to the goddess Hecate, it's going to be really powerful magic item.
He doesn't need that.
Okay. How about this? When you come back after the 6 months that we agreed to not tell Tim about, we'll give you the Wand of Hecate.
2 years.
I believe it was 6 months.
No.
We went back to two.
Did we go back? Okay, then two years, you will get the Wand of Hecate.
No, I'm getting the Wand of Hecate now.
That might be a problem.
Oh, you're going against your word. You already gave your word that you were going to. No, we haven't done that yet.
We gave the word that if you told us what you were going to do.
All right, I'm not
going to
help you then. I'm going to go.
Okay, I guess.
Bye.
Bye, Spitz. Is he still here?
Is he still here? He's still here.
So
Spitz.
We've played this game before, Spitz.
At this point, you have to know that I can see you.
You know what? Listen, I think we need to deal in good faith with this Spitz thing.
Yeah, right? I told you what the item was, and all of a sudden it's like, no, you can't have it.
We didn't say that.
We didn't say that.
Yeah, you did.
No.
Who said you did?
I never said you would get the item.
You'd get it 2 years later.
Oh, yeah, I did say that.
That, but this is part of negotiation.
Yep.
Yeah, well, that's not going to be, that's not fair.
You're saying
you found out, and now, and like, okay, well, you get your notes 2 years later.
I'm fine with that.
Are you?
Yeah.
Are you really?
I personally am. Oh, no?
Okay. I sort of want to be done with all of you anyway, so no, I'm not fine with that.
Oh, okay.
But.
It's me that gets the notes. So Cass doesn't care. Yeah.
Okay. I think we make the deal.
Can we at least agree that you could help us if Sebastian were to attack us or something with the Wand of Hecate? You would help us with the Wand of Hecate against Sebastian.
Yeah.
That doesn't seem
just
very
like we
good.
We would help defend you.
Well, I
with
know.
Scrolls.
I mean, like, I can help you with the wand of if I know how to use it.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I can't do something I don't know how to do.
Wait, are you trying to get the
wand? Are you getting
for
it for someone else?
For
yes.
Yeah.
I'll let you.
No, I want it for my personal collection.
The wands I have back in my little imp house.
No. I think I've already established that I work for somebody else.
That's true.
Which is, who isn't Sebastian?
No!
Okay.
Not Sebastian. Sebastian's bad. He's horrible.
Insight check. What do you know about Sebastian?
I know what I know from knowing you guys.
Oh. Okay.
Wasn't he the one who tried to get you guys killed? Wasn't he the one who...
I don't know.
...intended to be someone else and... captured people and swords and bows? Wasn't he the one who...
I only met him very briefly, so I don't know.
Stole
really anything.
A powerful item
material.
Of some sort.
Really?
Yeah.
Did he steal a powerful item? I don't recall this. He can't be that good.
I don't think he stole a powerful magic
no.
item. That's probably a little bit.
I think we've established that.
Those are stories.
I think your memory's lapsed.
Why don't you remind me?
I don't want to say it out loud.
Oh, that's fair.
I don't.
Because something might show up, or
I just know. Yeah, I'm not gonna mention it. I wouldn't mention it.
Really?
Not for all the.
I mean, you know who has it now,
right? I
don't
know what it is. I'm so intrigued.
Oh, because I do.
Well, I don't want to... He goes, for the first time ever, Spitz goes, I don't want to know.
Fair enough. I wouldn't tangle with
him. I mean, you've never heard him. I don't want to know. He goes, I don't want to know.
All right.
I don't want to know anything more about that.
So let's recap the deal.
Please.
Phew. Assist us in getting into the fortress.
All right.
Check.
Then to the temple.
Check. Information on Sebastian.
Yep.
Without...
Putting yourself in harm, yeah.
Chuck.
And we won't.
We will make every effort to protect Spitz if a fight breaks out.
Oh, and one more thing.
Yeah.
Throughout this contract, you will not work against us.
Ooh, that's good.
No, I'm working with you.
Yes.
No, I wouldn't think of it.
You'll take we'll put no action.
I mean, you know, we've worked together. Well, why would I endanger that?
And you will not do that.
And what am I getting?
Give me one second.
Protect
I'm writing this down
skin.
So you can sign it in your devil blood or whatever you do.
Please.
Well, not. I apologize.
Charcoal.
That's just flowing through your veins?
No, I just have lots of charcoal here so I can...
He is in a fireplace.
So you get
protection
the wand
from
of Hecate.
Tim. Wand of Hecate.
And the boots.
And
nope.
No.
And our protection what? Through this process.
You just said
well.
The wand.
Oh, yeah.
Boots. What boots are
boots.
You talking
the
about?
The boots, I need new boots. They're
what,
my boots.
What boots are you talking about?
I don't know. I'm just making a random guess.
I want the sword.
hoping there's a boot.
There's no boots. You get the wand of Hecate.
All right.
And we do not tell Tim for 2 years.
For 2 years.
We will not tell Tim unless magically coerced. Because Tim's pretty powerful.
Or physically coerced.
Or physically coerced.
Yeah.
All right.
I don't want
to. Unless our life is to tell put Tim. Into, no, as far as in particular, if our life is put into jeopardy.
Not tell Tim your whereabouts.
If he tortures us, then.
Yeah, I'm not getting tortured, Spitz.
Yeah.
I'm too afraid to get tortured, yeah.
I also would like to put in there that I want to be able to negotiate for any other items based on, you know.
Service rendered?
Yeah.
Okay.
So just
like if I save
her
ass.
You want a position of negotiation. You want right of.
Yeah, I mean, look, if I come through big time, I deserve a little.
I think that might be something we could do.
A little scratch, as we say in the underworld.
Right of negotiation.
That's
what they say in the underworld.
That's what they talk about.
You're so cool.
Scrap.
Loot.
Well, that's not as exciting.
For 2 years.
Nice.
Okay, all right. I think we're good. I mean, anybody else? You want to add anything else on there?
Let me show it to me.
So summarize.
No, I want to read it.
I just have a question.
I'll summarize it. Where'd you learn how to write?
Grade school.
Assist.
Bardic College. Which I failed out of. That.
What?
Yeah, it was really hard.
Assist us in getting into the fortress.
It was really hard. Then how are you a bard?
Self-taught, baby.
Gather as much information on Sebastian, you spelled it right, without self-harm as possible. Every effort to protect Spitz during this contract. Spitz will not work against us. Wand of Hecate for Spitz.
Oh, for Spitz, my apologies.
Yeah. You're not pulling anything over on Spitz, are you?
Nothing can be pulled in over your eyes, Spitz.
Just the flu.
Our Spitz, not tell Tim your whereabouts for 2 years, right of
negotiation.
Oh, that's an N. Okay.
I'm presuming he's out of the fireplace right now.
No, he has not come out of the fireplace.
Does this look acceptable to you?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're going to sign?
Yeah, I'll sign.
In blood.
You sign.
Sure. Give me a knife.
Well, I got one.
Okay.
That was rather fast.
I want demon blood on there. Sorry, devil blood. God.
Charcoal.
No, you ain't me signing blood. You're signing.
I'm not authorized to sign demon blood. I can only sign charcoal.
What about devil blood?
Well, devil blood because I'm low.
Wait, so.
I have to call.
Make sure it's binding.
Knowledge.
I have to sign in charcoal.
13 plus.
It needs to be binding.
Charcoal, he says.
That's persuasion as well.
I just got it.
17.
17?
Is he pulling a fast one?
It needs to be binding. That's all I care about.
Sounds pretty hinky.
Yeah.
To you.
I'm sorry. You're not pulling a fast one or anything like that.
Put it forward.
Hey, I can prick myself.
You could, and you are, so.
His tail comes out to his little finger.
I'm watching very closely.
Kind of sizzling, a little boiling.
Okay, cool.
Spitz.
I'm watching.
Excellent.
I'm going to roll an investigation on that.
All right.
17.
What are you looking for?
I'm just looking to make sure that he's not pulling a fast one.
No, he seems to actually do it. Yeah.
Clary's been watching him.
You read the contract over. You're okay with all the terms.
What did I do?
you said you'll never work against us, but that's fine, right? You were friends
assist
now.
Us with together.
There's no date, is there?
He'll never work against us.
It's only binding for the terms of this contract.
No, it doesn't say, unfortunately.
It doesn't say that. It just says you won't work against us.
You signed it already, Spitz.
We'll have to go negotiate later, I guess.
Well, yeah, you might.
Because I am the only signature.
During the terms of this contract,
that's
you're
true.
It's only contract between you and I.
Yeah. Yep. So I could let you out of it later. We'll negotiate, right?
Because he can work against any of the others.
Believe me, it's not binding in that.
I know.
It's only binding for that period of time.
Which is?
2 years.
2 years.
Oh, I'm fine with that.
Well, not working against us for 2 years, that's pretty good, too.
Yeah. 2 years goes by like that.
For you.
Well, then we can tell.
All right, Spence, what do we need to do? I mean, besides take a nap.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Are we safe to sleep here tonight?
You're going to go out in the blizzard?
That's not the question I asked.
Do
you know what this summoning...
Yeah, we're okay here.
do you know about this summoning circle? Like what it'll summon?
We're fine here.
Okay.
That wasn't an answer.
Well, why? I don't.
We're
I'm
working
gonna,
together.
I'm not contractually obligated to tell you anything.
Wow,
we're
gonna play
I don't know. He says, I don't know.
Do you know who controls this summoning circle?
No, not for sure.
Who created it?
No.
Is there anything unique about it, in your opinion?
It's probably for some powerful warlock or mage or something.
You know, I think that, you know, some warlocks and some mages have very signature styles of writing and script. Is there any type of, would you notice, would you recognize this script, handwriting style?
No, I don't know. I don't know it from anywhere.
All right.
All right, well.
I think we're good.
Yeah, I think we're
good. I mean, you know where this cabin is, don't you?
It's in the woods.
No.
Not really.
Yeah. I don't really know.
But you don't know where it is, do you?
Where are we?
He laughs.
Oh my gosh. You're not working against us and you're working with us.
I'm just
Where are we,
Spitz?
Far away.
So we're not on are we on the same plane?
Yeah.
We are. But we're not near Graver's Dig.
Where are we?
I mean...
And why can't you tell us? Or could you tell us, but you just don't want to?
It's time for bed.
Wow.
I'm tired, and I'll deal... Like, I didn't want to...
Do you know why it's snowing?
Sorry. Because it's cold here.
Why was it snowing at Graver's Dig?
That's true, it was.
I don't know. I think that has to do with, looks up. That has to do with something going on.
Upstairs.
Up there.
All right, well, it's rest time. We should do watches.
Yeah.
All right. I'll take first watch.
Okay.
He says,
are you sure it's snowing at Graver's Dig?
It was snowing when we left there. Or was it just getting cold?
It was snowing,
not in Graver's Dig, he goes.
But on the lake.
Yeah, on the lake.
Oh, the lake. That's a long ways from Graver's Dig.
Yeah.
All right.
I just need to be up at midnight, so.
All right.
Spitz, are you going to hang out with us all night?
Sure. I'm going to stay in the fire. It's nice and warm here.
That's fine.
All right.
Are you going to keep it going?
No.
Fuel. Will you be able to grab wood and put it on when you need it? Don't burn the cabin down.
Welcome to working with us, Spitz.
Everyone pulls their weight.
I'll keep the fire going.
You have to pull your weight around here.
I'll keep the fires going. Wait a second, that should be a tag along. Maybe it is. Anyway.
So we take.
You guys go. Any guys going to sleep?
Yeah, we're going to do rest.
So you do. You rest. You have a very restful sleep.
Oh, so nice.
And we'll stop here for a break.
Oh. Yeah.
So.
Uh-oh.
See if you wake up in the morning or not.
Spitz
isn't going to murder you. He's got a contract. Binding for 2 years, evidently. We'll be back in 15. Stay with us and find out what happens in the morning. And we'll see you soon.
Hello and welcome back to Actor Oki. We're returning after our short break where many things were discussed involving cats, dogs,
World of Warcraft.
World of Warcraft. What else what else did we discuss?
Rutabagas.
Rutabagas.
That was in my mind.
There was a side con. I didn't get. I wasn't in on the rutabaga.
What is a rutabaga?
It's like a turnip, but like the ugly child.
Oh, so it's the ugly child.
That's why I relate.
Of the turnip sound.
Okay. I actually don't know that, but it sounds right.
It does really seem like, oh yeah, here comes Mr. Rutabaga.
But a truffle is a mushroom.
It's true. Just so you're right. Really, the most expensive mushroom.
No, it's chocolate.
What?
Chocolate.
Also true.
So, what kind of pigs sniff out chocolate truffles?
Kill the brown ones.
Ones with really big noses.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm just.
I thought a joke, a punchline.
There was an actual question.
I was getting all excited.
Did you think I was going to have a joke?
Hold on, man. You see it over there.
It's called truffle sows.
Truffle sows. No, there's got to be a better joke. Anyway, write in and tell us.
Oh,
anyway.
We got truffles.
Do we wake up?
I'm not going to think.
Do we wake up? Are we awake?
Yeah. I assume we do.
Yeah, you do. Cool. You wake up. You feel refreshed.
Unusually refreshed?
Yes. You also have, you can roll your own. You have 2d10 extra hit points.
Extra?
Yes.
To heal or just on top of?
On top of. Like temporary hit points.
Oh, baller. Is that with our constitution added to it?
No, 2d10. Just 2d10.
2d10 flat. All right. All right.
19. and then this tipped over 13. To a 5, but it's a 19.
So it's like a 19, but. All right, come on.
Did you finally roll well?
High stakes.
Well, I don't have a.
Yes, I rolled a 10. It's a 2d10, right? Yeah. I rolled a 10 and a 9.
Wow.
I know.
It makes up for your 1s and 3s and 4s.
Some of us 16. Don't need temporary hit points.
Evidently.
I got 3.
Wait, no, that's a 10, right?
No, it's a 2 and 1. 2 and a 1.
We don't need those temporary hit points.
Stinking hit points.
You are also immune to poison for 24 hours.
Heroes Feast?
Yes.
Kind of. We ate some sort of chocolate pig. No, you just sleep and you are immune to poison.
It's good for you because they didn't tell you which was on the end of my dagger.
Also because some of us were almost killed by poison.
Yes.
When?
A couple days ago. It was rough.
Oh.
Yeah. Poison trap, explode in face. Nobody? Just me? Okay.
Just you.
Yeah, it was just you, wasn't it?
Yep.
After we told you not to do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, do that.
And you still
did it anyway.
I'll keep an eye out for traps this time.
Thank you.
Sorry I wasn't there earlier.
Oh, he knew the trap was there.
I did.
What? Is it?
I thought it was a magical trap.
But it was a trap.
But it was a trap. Well, not a magical trap.
So we're immune to poison.
Mm-hmm. You're immune to poison, 2d10 extra hit points. Yep. That's what you've...
That's it?
That's it.
And is Spitz still there?
Spitz is still there. Spitz.
Did you keep the fire going?
Yeah,
hey, fire's Spitz, going. Do you know how to cook?
Huh?
Are you a good cook?
I can cook.
Really? Are you good though?
Barbecue? Well, not. Can you grill some sausages?
Do you have sausages?
I figured the larder. No.
Check it out.
Oh, I'll check the larder. Oh no.
Oh, I'm not opening
sausages.
Anything.
Hey.
Nice.
You know, listen. If you're
eggs,
a good cook,
beer.
Beer. Some nice vino.
Eggs and sausages.
What about some large cap mushrooms?
Yeah.
No.
Dang.
What about some, what else with toast?
I have
mushrooms. There
mushroom.
Is fresh greens.
Cybacillin mushrooms.
Root vegetables.
Small cap mushrooms.
Do you only eat mushrooms?
No, I just don't eat meat.
That's right.
What about bok choy? Any bok choy?
How much bok choy does Archibald eat?
This much.
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
When? You mean like, you know,
you have the makings for a nice udon noodle soup with bok choy.
Oh, and
yeah. With the, all of the stuff.
I would love some breakfast bok choy soup, udon soup. Spitz.
So Spitz starts cooking.
Breakfast bok choy. Vegetarian,
please. By the way, thank you for keeping the fire.
Yeah absolutely.
We're looking forward to
I'm not the best one to cook. I don't know how to make human food.
That's a good point.
I mean, I'm just going to burn.
Well, neither do my mother. So
here's me and human food. Burn it! Burn it!
Okay, I could cook.
I'm sure you can.
don't know what that means.
What does that even mean?
Is there any haggis in leather?
What?
No, somebody's asking on.
Haggis?
Haggis.
Haggis?
I mean, haggis isn't bad.
Who's asking for haggis? Is this Connor?
Steve underscore Connard.
Yeah. The truffle is a specially bred pig with a passion for culinary adventures and a remarkable talent for sniffing out the most delectable chocolate truffles. With a coat that resembles the rich hues of a dark chocolate.
You're listening, right, Tanel?
This is incredible.
True fluff.
Okay, good.
Truffluff.
The truffluff.
I need more truffluff.
Charming and efficient in its truffle hunting pursuits.
Wow.
Well, the boars in the truffluff are...
Thank you very much.
Talk about you a think brain, we you can, don't want to be,
we
like,
can make up instant
in.
Monsters here. Instant monsters, instant animals.
That's what we could have
done. The walrus, I mean, it's all. It's like,
so I guess
like
Tanel,
okay.
The walrus is not made up.
The walrus is real. I mean, real. What?
Whoa. Some people call the truffluff the land walrus, but it's not.
The walrus is real. The walrus is real.
The walrus is real. It's real. It's real, I tell you. All right, so in any case, yeah, there's plenty of food there. He goes, you might want to check outside, though.
Oh, no.
Look out the window.
No.
You can't see out the window.
Snow.
Great.
What does that mean? Is that flames?
You are like, yes, the snow all the way.
That's fine. Wait, does the door open in or out?
The door opens in.
So if we open it, snow would come in?
No, it should be packed.
Yeah, unless it's too packed.
Unless there's no physics here either.
That's true.
Yes, physics.
Wait. Are we gonna do a campaign with physics this time or without?
I think physics might be.
I think we've established there's physics because the fire's been burning the whole night. Kind of like it's not
Except for Spitz did hold the paper and it didn't catch on fire.
Yeah.
So we did agree that there's not
something
really.
Out,
that's a chemical change.
That would have been hilarious.
Spitz grabs the paper
and goes, poof. He goes, oh shoot.
Oh no.
I'm going to cook breakfast for everyone, Spitz included, and I'm going to preserve as much of the food as I can, so that way we can have refiller rations.
How are you going to preserve it? Like,
I don't know. I'm just going to smoke it while we're waiting. I guess. I don't know.
No, like
whatever carries well. Now.
Salt and lye.
Yeah,
use salt and lye.
I'm not going to use lye.
Thank you, Norwegian. I know exactly. Salt and lye. Just salt the salt and lye.
Lutefisk. We have sausage fisk. Egg fisk.
Egg fisk. All the fisks.
So much fisk.
So you preserve meats in your own fashion.
I'm not going to really get into that. But
yeah, we don't need to.
But. So yeah, okay.
Re-rationed everybody.
So, you know, you serve up some food. It's good.
All right. We good.
Everyone eats. They're feeling good.
The spells that you got and I got today are not water-based because we're assaulting a fortress.
That's true. Yeah.
Cool. Just want to make sure we did that already, and we did.
Assaulting a fortress?
I trust you to get us inside, Spitz.
Well, what? I thought you wanted me to. I thought you wanted to do some investigation first.
That's true.
According to the contract, investigation. You want me to investigate?
This is us in getting into the fortress.
Doesn't it say? Didn't you say you wanted me to investigate?
Oh, I don't have to do
as much information on Sebastian.
Well, he's there. So what am?
You know, it's a long. We'll talk about it on the way. Anyway, take out the snow globe.
Oh, is that the snow globe? Which one?
I take out the one that
one do you take out?
To where? The one that wasn't working.
Yeah, I'll take out the one that wasn't working just in case.
Yeah,
it doesn't seem like it's snowing still, but...
Oh, you mean the
temple.
The temple?
Yeah.
You see a kind of a deep blue kind of colorization of the water.
It's deep blue? Like it was different from the last
time? Yeah, there's some sort of... The light is playing, there's some
an
sort
issue, but it's not working.
Like there's snow there?
It's underwater.
There's the ice layer and all the walruses are on top of it. Keeping the ice cold.
That's not the sound they make.
Yeah.
Like that? It's like...
Why would a walrus make that sound?
I'm just trying to go
all right. So
when they say
along.
Whip, they say whip. Because there's a lot of whip in all the things that they say.
Yeah.
We'll get a fish in him. All right, stop. We'll get a fish. We'll get officially sanctioned walrus sounds later.
I can't. I have to leave.
I mean, we're not going to spend the rest of the night doing walrus. Walrus.
I gotta go.
Half an hour.
But I gotta go.
I just had a skill show up on my sheet. Segway.
Nice.
Plus 20.
Oh, nice.
Okay, we're changing the subject.
So anyway, I pull out the one to the Temple of Hecate because I think that's where we need to go.
All right. So the one.
Sorry, not the temple. The
statue
of Hecate. It's not Freya. By statue, not Hecate.
Statue of Freya.
It's Freya.
Yeah, not
wow.
Hecate.
Statue of Freya.
I got that wand of Hecate on my mind.
Yes. It is. There's a lot of snow around it, and you can see her. And remember, the view was you can see her, and then over into the lake.
Yeah.
The lake is completely frozen over.
Ooh, dang.
Real cold winter.
Oh, so do we have wintry things to wear?
I don't.
Absolutely.
I wonder if there's anything in this armoire over here.
The sound effects.
Let me try that again. I wonder if there's anything in this armoire over here.
Yes.
Yay!
You find some winter clothes.
I put on some winter clothes.
Strange.
Some that fit Clary and I.
Yeah.
Well, they're a little long.
Great.
Do we find scissors?
No. Oh.
Oh, Clary. Spitz. There's me and
Spitz. By the fire.
Clary's going, Spitz. I see you.
Yeah. She does see her. Nice.
That's a great contract. Right.
We have knives. We can cut the ends off.
Oh, yeah.
We don't need scissors.
Okay.
You're going to cut the clothing?
Just two knives.
I've got crafting 25, so.
Oh, nice. All right. Cool.
Craft yourself some clothes.
Yep.
Just got a shortening.
Yeah.
So a little tightening.
So you put on some heavier clothing.
Yep.
And then will you want to look around out here?
There's
first?
A very nice walrus sweater in there, too.
Mm.
I call it.
Is there a walrus hat with the little flappy
ears? I hope it has designs
and the tusks.
On it.
Yes! Goes down the side. Please let me get a walrus took.
All right. There is not one in there, but
it's
if you guys want to have one made,
it's a walrus helm.
Walrus.
I only wear something that's walrus. If there isn't, I'm not wearing it.
Me too.
There's only one walrus sweater.
The devil wears a walrus.
I don't even know what that means.
Groundbreaking.
I mean,
it's okay. Moving on.
I know what it means. I just thought.
Do we
sure
want to
I
investigate
know.
Here before we go? Do you want to try and go out in the snow and just check around out here?
I don't.
I don't know. Listen, you know what? You do you. It seems warm in here and cold out there.
I don't think we're going to be able to get far with the snow so high that we can't really even get through the door. Unless we're
when
tunneling.
We came here, we appeared outside, correct? Mm-hmm. And
yeah.
We went in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if we need this as an escape route. It might behoove us to clear this area out
that's
little
a good
bit.
Point.
You might be the new thinker in the group.
No.
can you look at the your snow globe for this Which, place?
Oh, good.
What does it actually look like?
Good idea. See, smarter.
Fair.
It looks like a scene outside where you can see the very top of the chimney sticking out, and that's it, and the smoke coming out. And it's all covered in snow, and the place is completely
Yikes.
Covered in deep, deep snow, probably 10 feet of snow.
So it's possible that we could open the door, bury, and make a hole all the way up. Mm-hmm. But
so we could drop in.
Claire, you want to do a knowledge nature, please?
Me?
Yeah.
Go, Claire.
It's real cold.
Oh, that would be an 8. Not very good.
I
don't know. I don't know nothing.
17.
All right. So, I mean, this is,
I don't know nothing.
This is, you are in a tropical area, and this is completely unusual and weird and strange.
Killing
now,
plants.
Now, winter is in the sky, and so.
What does that mean?
That's the Anumian in the sky. It's like a constellation,
yes.
But
right.
It's actually a thing.
Got
that affects
it.
The world.
Got it.
It's an actual. Some people believe, and it's an actual being.
Wait, so
powerful
knowledge on that. What is the knowledge on that? It's like what I'm trying to figure out is like, would we, since these constellations do come around, and we're old enough to understand that, is this a normal occurrence when that particular thing is in the sky?
You can do a knowledge on that.
Does winter normally just screw up all the jungles and go, you know what?
I mean, we may be basing it off our understanding of weather and tropics, but yeah. If it's a normal thing, we would probably just know.
No, it's not normal. That's okay, the thing.
Okay, well then, like, I think just know this.
Yeah, not it's normal. Not normal.
Something this going is on not, with
something's
this
is messed nothing. Up. Yeah, someone's pissed off.
Something's happening.
Someone's definitely pushing the wrong end of the scale.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But anyway.
All right.
So, we did this roll that was around digging a hole to at least have a hole access.
Yeah, it would take you a long time unless you have some way.
Just a hole. I mean, just a hole from the door and just go straight up.
Do you not have any fire cantrips? Any little fire magics?
You mean you want me to work for it?
All right, I want you to work a little.
Like, does anybody have a shovel of excavating?
I have.
Nah, we'd give that away.
Wait, you want something hot and warm? Fits?
Huh?
What? Oh yeah, Fitz.
Yeah.
Spitz.
Spitz.
Not Fitz.
Fitz is his cousin.
Who's Fitz?
Owes him money.
I don't know. Fitz. Look, nothing personal.
He's your Taylor brother.
That's a good point.
Right.
Yeah. Just send him out. Kind of out a little.
No, I'll go out.
You so won't. Like,
if you no, go I'll out. Just like go out.
Yeah. Really?
Oh no, you won't.
It's too cold.
Let's dig this hole when we come to.
Really? You don't have strong enough fire.
Let's cross this bridge when we come to it.
Yeah.
Let's find this cabin when we need to.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm not a fire. I was just worried.
I'm not an elemental. I'm not a fire creature. I can't just Johnny Storm it.
I mean, like, I can produce a flame and melt it.
Never mind.
What?
Because I can't just do that.
I can produce flame into my hands and melt our way out.
Yeah, yeah. Like, don't worry
or
about
in.
It.
Or in, yeah.
Okay, I'm just thinking about exit plan.
So, in or out, depending.
Right. Yeah. But I think we go to the Statue of Freya.
I heard it, too. It's okay.
Okay. Am I the only one? All right.
No, I just
so, Statue of Freya. You go to the Statue of Freya. So, you know, all right. So you're use the snow globe, open up a portal in the cabin.
I thought so, yeah.
Why not?
Okay.
Anybody going to stop me?
Mm-mm.
I guess I don't think we can do it. Yeah.
All right. It opens up.
Looks cold.
Oh, nice.
Let's go. I'm very excited. Let's go through.
We will have made Spitz some little clothes.
Yes, Spitz has a little outfit now, too, to keep
him. He's invisible.
Warm.
Oh, you mean an out? Oh, that's very nice of you.
Just stay warm.
I mean, or you can be cold.
We don't want him to go out.
Can I have those little things that you guys wear on your hands?
Yeah.
Yes.
Tennis rackets.
Rings.
No, you
got
a ring.
Glovies.
Got a ring for me?
Gloves.
No, ring. Mittens. Well, we're not Let's giving make you any little mittens. Rings.
Little mittens?
Yeah.
Do they call them mittens?
Yeah. Mittens yes. are like.
One. What are mittens?
They used to be made of cats, and you would just wear cats on
that's
your hands.
That's kittens.
Yeah.
What?
That's where it comes from, right?
Yes. Wait. Huh?
You guys are weird. You wear cats on your hands?
No.
We used to, and then we decided that walrus was a better material than cat.
Yeah.
The live cats. We wouldn't hurt the kittens. Walrus. That's just better.
Do you wear a walrus on your hand?
Walrus helms.
Yeah. If you can.
They're walrus kittens. Wait. Mittens.
It'll keep your hands warm. Since you're not an elemental, you might go out, so we want to keep you warm.
Okay, but what's a mitten? I mean, he says a cat.
Clary described it.
A mitten is like one big pocket for most of your little fingies versus gloves, which are...
For each one.
Yeah.
Single tubes.
For each fingie.
How many fingies does...
How many fingies
do
you
four.
Have?
Okay. He's got four.
So it'd be one like
thumb
three.
And three.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if it goes over
three...
That's
why mittens would be easier for us to make for you.
Yeah.
Who can make mittens?
We're already done. Here they are.
Does everyone have snowshoes?
Yes.
Snowshoes.
Cool. Done.
What? No, you don't got snowshoes. Nice try.
I wonder if there are snowshoes in this armoire.
No.
What about tennis rackets for pickleball?
No.
Wait. What?
No.
You don't
no
use tennis rackets
item.
For pickleball?
No, nothing for...
Okay.
No snowshoes.
How deep, you guys? So looking at how deep is the
snow? It's very deep.
by the temple of
I mean, it's remember
like
10
feet?
Yeah, it's almost, it's about 6 or 7 feet.
Wait, so like,
so you would be in, I mean, you're going to come into just.
It's difficult terrain.
Well, more than difficult.
Okay.
Yeah, it'd be hard to move. That's the dilemma.
Too bad I can't summon that sleigh yet.
Right?
Yeah.
That'd be really
too bad.
Handy.
That's a seventh level.
What can you turn into?
Oh, it's a seventh level spell.
Yeah.
What can you turn into?
A lot of things.
How about a snow beast of some kind?
Like what? I've never seen a snow beast.
You've seen a walrus.
I've seen a walrus.
If you turn into a walrus, you could pull us along on a on one of these carpets.
Don't they have scales and they're super slick on the bottom?
No.
Yeah. Oh.
I could turn into a bear.
What type of bear?
A big bear.
A polar bear?
No, I've never seen a polar bear.
Okay, can't do that.
I'm gonna take the rug that's not covered.
I'm from the I'm foresty.
The pentagram
swamps.
And like lay it out.
Maybe like 5 rats.
Theoretically, the rug is
going to
have some sort of waterproofing on the bottom because otherwise
split
it would wake
the little rabbits.
And so, this rug is at least big enough, hopefully, for a couple of us to get on, and maybe a bear could pull us with a rope.
Okay.
Or just flip the table upside down.
Yes.
Go sledding.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We should decide soon, though, because the portal
Yeah, the portal's closed in 10
for
minutes.
For 10
yeah.
squirrel minutes.
10 squirrel minutes, my apologies.
10 squirrel
Wait,
minutes.
When we go there, what are we going to do?
We're trying to get to the fortress.
Can we get a hold of Dickens?
No.
Well, he has the sleigh.
Oh, that's true. All right. Reach my head out. Dickens? Sorry.
All right.
I can maybe do it.
Let's go through.
I think a table. Table, flip it over. I'm going to take the table and the rug.
Okay. Why not? Clara, do you have a way to... talk to Dickens?
I think so.
All right.
Give me a second.
We could ask Tim. Just kidding.
So, I'm not hindered by difficult terrain. Right. And I know that this is a little deeper than that. But if I gave myself a strength bonus, maybe I'd be able to pull you guys on our ramshackle sleigh of a table.
This would be a little more than difficult terrain.
I figured.
But it would help you a little.
Would conjuring animals work to get
Dickens like, conjure an animal, help you get Dickens?
Yeah.
Just summon a reindeer.
I could do that.
Yeah, then, but even, like, it's 7 feet deep.
Okay, what stands on 7 feet deep snow? Because I don't think anything does. Oh, what could burrow through 7 feet of snow?
Not us.
Can we swim through it? Is it packed enough, or is it light and fluffy enough we can swim?
Do a perception check when you're looking through.
5.
18.
10.
You can see beyond, and you see the ice. Well, there's wind kind of whipping on the ice, and the ice is bare.
We just need to get to the ice.
We just need to get to the ice.
But that's 900 feet down.
But it's 900 feet down. What do we do? I was lying about feather falling before, so...
That's not a thing?
Oh, no.
Wait, I joined you because you said you could feather fall.
Yeah,
down.
Oh,
I wasn't planning on that.
Spitz goes, what? Just fly. Could you fly? Could you fly?
I mean, I could fly.
Can you fly us?
Can you fly?
How big are you?
Can anyone fly?
I mean, it can be as big as I...
Like a massive giant eagle that can, like, carry us up and down?
Yeah, I mean, we still have to take turns,
I heard some great wizards have that happen sometimes.
Can you hippogriff?
Hippogriff? No, I can't do that. Unfortunately.
And I could still increase your strength, so that way you can carry two of us at a time. Spitz could help.
Spitz could help, I guess.
I can't hippogriff, but I can nerdogriff.
I can't. He goes, yeah, Spitz goes, I can't fly you down. I can barely fly myself.
Yeah, that's fair. You are
small.
Barely helpful.
Teeny.
Yep. looking to see if I could possibly mm-hmm. have Featherfall. Because that sounds like more and more a better spell to have.
Turn into a giant eagle. I could also turn into an imp. We could just have two imps.
We could also just lower a couple of ropes, put some pitons in, attach that rope, unattach it up top, drop it down, and just go down like that. I'm not good at climbing. I don't think that's a good idea, but...
As we're at the top of this by
yeah.
Great Freya, does it slope off to the sides at all?
It does gradually, but away from the lake, not really. It doesn't go straight down to the lake.
So the lake's really deep down in there.
Yeah, it's way down, yeah.
And so
this side.
And we're, so like, here's the lake, here's Freya, fortress is over there.
Yeah, so on this side, it's very tall, because there's a mountain that's going up
behind
this way,
us.
Behind us. And she's on the promontory looking out over it, and then it goes, slopes down, and the lake is
so
down below.
So it slopes down.
Slopes, yes.
How steep of a slope?
Pretty steep.
Irregular, or like pretty nice and easy?
Yeah,
even?
Well, rocky, irregular, and trees, and... That kind of thing.
So we couldn't slide on the table down there?
Not without busting it up eventually, probably.
The table or us?
A giant eagle yet?
Huh? Well, both.
Okay.
What can you turn into that can carry anyone?
Nothing. Little things.
Yeah. There we go.
I love that one. It's so good.
We could also just try to climb. It's not sheer.
But it's the 7 feet of snow. That we keep coming to.
Yeah, you have quite the dilemma here.
Would 7 feet of snow break our fall and not break our legs?
Possibly.
Falling 900 feet?
But you said it's sloped.
No. Oh, no, no, I'm, no.
I turn into a...
It's a cliff straight down from here to the lake.
It's sloped along the sides, going down around.
Right. So could we maybe slide on the table down on the side?
Well, like I said, there are trees and rocks, and you could go for a while and eventually just break it up.
Let's just wait till spring thaw. No?
I don't know if that'll work.
Okay.
What if, Clary, do you happen to have a spell called Flaming Sphere? Because if we just made a flaming sphere through, we could just crawl tunnel.
Yeah.
I don't know.
For long enough? I don't think you can do it long enough.
Guys.
I have wall of fire, but.
No matter what, we're going to have to get out there. We have cold weather gear. We have the heart of a warrior's.
And you have about 4 minutes before you're.
Yeah,
and
we have to decide what we're doing.
Closing in 4 minutes. So chuck the table out. Chucking a rug out.
Let's go.
I'm looking around for ropes, anything that could really help us.
I mean, I've got some rope, but...
Like, but do you have 900 feet of rope?
No. I have 1/9 of that.
We searched the house, right? Is there anything in the cabin at all?
No, there's nothing else in here that you think could help you. Okay. I mean...
Other than the rune is, you know, we don't want to try the...
Maybe we can summon something.
Like what?
Bless you.
No.
Summon something?
I can't. Can you? I'm really thinking that we summon something that could jump on top of the 7 feet of snow, but what about a giant ice frog?
3 minutes.
An ice frog? I mean, I could try. I
got all that stuff out. I'm going to go outside the portal and hang out.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll go out there with you. I'm not doing any good here.
Right.
Wait, so you step into
you're going through the portal.
Yeah. Yeah.
Snow.
You put the snow, the table, and the rug on the snow for a landing place.
Yep.
It probably sinks probably about like 3 feet.
It kind of sinks in a little, but it's pretty, it's pretty dense. It's a lot. There's a lot of snow. So you kind of like get on the table, and it's like, where do I go now?
I have very short legs.
Fair enough. What if
are you guys stepping out too?
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay. So you all step out. Spitz goes, steps out.
What if we cut the table?
He starts flying up.
In quarters.
You see him. It's like
cut the table.
Cut the table in quarters. and then we walk on it.
Spitz flies like down.
Spitz, where are you going?
Right back.
He said I'll be right back.
Yeah. He said he's gonna assist us. So
he just left.
I trust him right now due to a binding contract.
I like your idea.
I think it has what we can do.
Basically cut up the table and sort of try and make it like snowshoes.
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea.
It's all we got. Yeah. Oh, we should have grabbed the chairs too. Hmm. Wait, the portal's still open?
For like a minute and a half, yeah.
Yeah, fine, go ahead, grab it.
Yeah, grab some chairs.
Throw away some chairs out of the portal.
Check some stuff out.
This looks good. Watch out for this.
Yep.
Oh wait, that's a hammer. It's just gonna go right,
never mind.
So then we have giant square platforms with some rope, and then they
has
have-
Has Spitz come back yet?
No, not yet.
If we could take that door off the hinges, we could just sit on that too.
Portal closes, everything you had disappears.
Oh good, great.
Figured.
Everything you brought.
Yeah, brought Where's through Spitz? That portal.
My sausages!
Including our warm weather?
Yes.
Cool.
Oh no!
It's cold.
The snow disappears?
No, nice try though. So it's cold.
Yeah.
All right, guys.
So we and our clothes disappear?
Yeah. You're yeah. Cold.
All right, I'm going to start trying to make my way because there's nothing else we can do besides
Well, you cars. Really can't make your way.
Let's go.
I mean, you can maybe.
Let's go closer to the statue to try and clear so if you get, the base of the statue.
So you can get off underneath kind of the statue and you can get to the base of it.
Oh, I lost my
Spitz thing. Comes back after a while. Flame. He flies back up. He says, there's some really weird thing going on down there.
What do you mean?
Well, there's these him. There's four of him. And they're
Our gnome friends.
And they're down
Redheads?
There. And they've got these weird things on and they're just kind of like going whoosh, whoosh, like this, whoosh. And they're moving across the ice.
Oh.
I have no clue what that could be.
Are they like little blades or are they like long flat things?
They're like long blade things, like weird bones.
I roll to learn like about bones. Skis.
You roll to learn about what it could be.
Yeah. Ice skates.
Oh, skis.
Ice skates.
No.
I think it's...
What?
What's your country of origin, by the way? Your character's country of origin.
I am from... God, where is it? I know it's... Out of character, I know that it's Chaldea equivalent of Russia.
Okay. Azerbaijan.
Azerbaijan. Wow, nice. Oh, are you? From there?
Oh.
Okay, these are skis. Excuse me, these are skates. These guys are on skates or skis or something like that on the ice.
Okay.
If that's where you're from, that's.
I don't know.
I mean, I've seen this before on ice.
I can't remember.
It's
Steve will correct me.
Augstadt. That's Germany.
No.
It's not Azerbaijan. It's something different.
No. It's. I don't remember what it is. I don't remember. Steve will tell us right now.
Yeah. Steve.
And then and the other thing is.
Oh, Steve.
And you've also seen the show Gnomes on Ice. So.
I remember that.
That's good. Yeah.
Gnomes.
I got a one. By
the cliffhanger.
The Kingdom of Roosh.
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 Yeah. Got it.
I'm Rooshin.
Cool.
Rooshin.
Why didn't I think about that?
Ice skates. Can we call Golden Eagles? I hear that they can like save anybody.
No. Did Steve Connor say that?
Yeah.
Oh, you! A long-standing feud between Steve
just
and
have
I.
The Golden
feud
Eagles
is too hard of a word.
Drop the ring
discussion.
Into the fire.
I don't think I can make skates.
So anyway, he says they're down there. They're just like going across. Look at
900 feet.
Yeah, but they're there.
Tell them to
come pick us up.
Tell them.
No,
like, go show higher. Up.
Yeah, I wouldn't show up.
I didn't
them.
Say that.
Oh. Yeah. Can you give me something? Like something to show I'm helping you.
I could write a note that says, "Please help Spitz save us to save you. It's your friends, the adventurers from the boat."
Is that gonna work? Do you have a signet ring or something that they would know? Do you have something that they would
your
like?
Pendant.
I don't think they would know my signet.
I know something.
I don't have that ring.
You have that ring.
I have a dwarven ring.
You have that ring thing. That ring.
I don't have a ring.
One of you have that ring.
I have a dwarven ring.
The zombie ring.
Oh.
No one that currently is sitting at this table has that ring.
Yeah. And you're not getting her zombie ring, Spix.
Well, I was going to use it as a token.
No.
How about that necklace you got?
What about this necklace?
Well, like they would know what that was. I could take it to them.
No, they wouldn't.
Okay.
Actually, you know what? I got an idea.
Like what?
My holy symbol.
Oh.
That sounds like a great idea.
Yeah. It's a pretty specific holy symbol, right? Yeah, you want to look over it. That way you can make sure that the one we get back is the correct one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes. This holy symbol of...
Anubis.
The holy symbol of Anubis.
Anubis?
It's a ladle.
Yes. Oh, yeah. This holy symbol of Anubis. This is...
The ladle of Anubis.
This is right. The ladle... Yeah, the
famous ladle of Anubis.
Says, well, I mean, it will become famous.
And really, this is...
Spitz goes...
Gas's
holy symbol.
So I'm going to go down to the gnomes, I'm going to take them a ladle, and they're just going to kill me.
But if you tell them that it is Cass the Bard's holy symbol and he has entrusted you with it, can you touch my holy symbol? Let's find out.
That's a great...
What's the god?
Anubis, god of death.
Anubis, death. Hold on a sec, don't get your eyes close to me. Just one sec. Anubis. Think about Anubis. Anubis. Yeah, I'm gonna give it a try.
All right.
Takes it.
Cool.
Oh yeah. It feels good.
All right. Yeah. Don't like it. Don't. I do want it back, but.
I was like, I can fly down there, but then I have to shape out a wild shape, and I can't wild shape back, so I would just be stuck down there.
Go down there.
You don't want that.
I don't
want
to
do that.
Talk to him, let him know that we're stuck, and we need assistance.
So, okay.
We can write a note, though, and you can fly it down there and drop the note with Spitz.
I could do that, yeah.
Okay, drop a note. I need as much collateral as possible.
So you could actually just go with Spitz.
That's the wrong word, but.
Yeah, but if I, so here's the thing.
Charlotte's
going to
come with
you. I can wild shape.
Charlotte.
Oh, what?
I can wild shape and fly down there, but if I wild shape out, I can't wild shape back to get back up here.
Well, we don't want
to
be up
here. No, just drop off the note. You just wild shape to go down there and drop off the note with your claws and fly back.
Why would she fly back? She'd get down there. She'd get down there.
Yeah, but then I'm by myself down there without the rest of my friends.
You have four gnome friends.
You have the gnomes.
You have Spitz with you.
That's fair.
You have Spitz. I'll be there. Okay.
Okay.
I have the power.
Are we sure that there are gnome friends
evil gnome? Yeah, there probably are gnomes.
What, evil gnomes?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Man, we get up to some crazy things.
I guess
I'm going to go
don't
down
look at me.
There.
I'm not evil.
They look like they're having too much fun to be evil.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, he's got a point. Evil people don't have fun unless it's evil stuff and skating on the ice.
That's true.
It's definitely not
okay,
evil.
Okay, I'll go I'll wild shape down there and go with you.
I can see it
and
already.
And then I'll stay down there.
Yeah, just stay down there. It'll be fine. They're going to come get us.
Why do you stay? No, just fly down there with our note. When Fitz is down there, drop the note to confirm, so they see it and fly back up if you're worried. Mm-hmm. Like, you can fly and go caw, 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 flap our direction like this.
But what? Oh, okay.
I could do that, I guess.
What are we doing? He says... What are you guys doing?
You are going to go down there, Spitz, with the holy symbol. We're going to write a note. Yes. No, the holy symbol. And we're going to write a note saying that we're up here, that this is Cass's holy symbol. We're going to give the note to a bird Charlotte, who's going to fly down, drop the note from her
talons,
drop it right there, and then they can go, caw, caw, like, indicating that up here.
But why is she going back?
Why should she stay down there?
Well, because she's gonna be, don't you wanna? Don't you wanna get down here?
Well, we do, yeah.
But so one less of you.
You're making me agree with Spitz, guys. Just.
If there are our gnome friends, I will stay.
All right.
If I don't know these gnomes, then I'll come back.
Oh, if they're, if they're.
Evil gnomes.
Evil.
Well, I mean, dire I just gnomes. Don't know all of them.
I think that they're great. There's no
nasty
race
gnomes.
Like gnomes.
Can we agree on nasty gnomes?
Well, I'm going to turn into an owl.
Bad gnomes.
I'm going to wild shape into an owl.
Okay.
wise
write, move. Write down a note.
What?
Also what? Add in wise there that move. I'm who I am. Thanks.
Who?
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 Down you go. Yeah, Spitz goes, go Spitz flies. You see him. He's invisible, yep. But he flies. He's got his ladle.
Just a ladle floating in the air.
No, it's visible.
Noted. Okay.
And but yeah, you I mean yeah, you could see him, and he's going down and coming down, and you see they kind of look up at this. You see it, this owl, big mm-hmm. owl flying down, and they're looking at it. They're looking at the owl, and they're skating on the ice. They seem to be kind of like, I mean, they look like they're actually having a little bit of fun.
And they are the ones that we
yeah.
met.
Okay. Yeah, it's the older fatherly gnome.
Yeah.
And it's the two sons and the other fighter. Yes.
Hobbs meat roaster.
So not the evil gnome.
No, there are our no, friends.
No, it's not this guy. It's not the evil gnomes.
Okay.
There's no evil gnomes.
I need some gnomish contraptions, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna give them the. Shoes. I'm gonna drop the note.
Yes.
You drop the note.
Can I land on like one of their shoulders? Are they gonna freak out?
Which one are you gonna land on?
Papa.
Okay. Yeah, he doesn't freak out. He just looks, kind of looks at you like, hello?
And drop the note into his
hand. All right, he goes,
into his hand.
Looks at the note. Looks up, goes, okay? Hello?
Okay, I'm in a wild shape out. I'm gonna get off of him in a wild
shape
out.
I thought it might be you.
Yeah. Everybody else is up there, and we don't know how to get through the snow. Do you have any?
You mean you want to sort of get down here?
Yeah.
Because the wind is erased
no
all
the lake.
Yeah.
All the snow from the lake, so yeah. It's icy. You need skates down here, or something. Or if you can't skate, then something to grip the ice. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got to slip all over, but you could go slow.
Sure.
But at least you can go at this terrain. So how are we going to get you down?
Yeah.
We should be listening.
Well, you guys aren't listening. He's having a conversation with her. So,
how did y'all get down?
We weren't up.
Oh, you weren't up. You were just up. Okay.
Yeah, we weren't up there. We were doing this. Once the lake started to freeze and there's a lot of commotion over at the fortress, but we're a long ways from it because we're below, right below the statue. I mean, so they're on that side of the lake. So he says, but
hey, Spitz.
Who's Spitz goes? Yeah.
Give me Cass's ladle back.
Drops it and they go look around and goes, what's a Spitz?
Annoying. Oh. And I'm just gonna put it in my little bag.
Is he a familiar?
Spitz
doesn't
friend.
Say. Is he helping you?
He's helping us, yes.
Okay, so we gotta, but he can't help you get down. And you could get down, but they can't.
Yeah.
Because they don't have a way to go down that cliff, right?
Yeah. But we can send information back with Spitz to help them get down if we can figure out a... Like, do you have any contraptions that we can use? Parachutes or something that would help them float
well,
to the ground?
Well, we kind of have some...
Or
I mean, you know
climbing
what?
Gear?
No, but I have a... Well, I have a... I have a couple items, he says, and this is the Papa guy. He says, I have a couple items that could get them down.
Mm-hmm.
So we might, if we could get them up to him, maybe they could try and use them.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, yeah.
How are we going to get them up there, though?
Spitz.
Is Spitz big?
Oh, how big?
Well, he kind of... Reaches into, he kind of reaches takes his backpack off,
uh-huh.
reaches in and pulls out a long, kind of like, it looks like it's about 5 feet long device that seems to.
Okay.
Out mm-hmm. and it has these little, contraption,
uh-huh.
little seat, and a little thing.
That would be perfect.
Yeah, there's a lot of wind though, but then if you don't know how to use them, you have to kind of.
Figure it out.
But if we can get those up there, we can get one of them or two of them up there, then
they
can come
rope?
Down. Yeah, I've got lots of rope.
Lots of rope? Can we tie?
We have lots of rope.
Can we tie rope to the end of it and then send the rope up with Spitz?
And then pull them up.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's do that.
All right, let's do that.
Can Spitz carry a rope up there?
Spitz, can you carry a rope?
I'm going to carry a rope.
Yeah, he's going to carry. He's working with us, so he's going to carry
the rope. I don't see
a
Spitz, though.
You don't want to.
Oh, really?
I mean, he's fine.
But you trust him.
I do trust him. Okay. Unfortunately, right now, I do.
All right. Yeah. Unfortunately?
You know, there were some debates, but he's on our side right now, so okay. We're good. For two years.
Is he going to help us with the fortress?
He is. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, all right. Well, I'm gonna trust that you know what you're doing. So he gets the rope out. Spitz gets it. Some rope starts going. Yep.
Spitz, you're going to take this up and tell them to pull it up.
So Spitz. He kind of goes erratic and to the side every once in a while.
He's a lot.
He flies up and he gets higher.
Can we see? Oh, yeah. Not at the edge.
No, right? No, you're not at the edge. But pretty soon you hear a voice. Help! Help! Come to the help! And Spitz is like, going help. He becomes visible. You can see a little rope in his claws, and he's trying to fly above, and he's like getting blown to the side.
Do we have any weight?
Yeah, I got a rope of climbing, so I go like 60 feet with the rope of climbing. That's about as far as it can go, but I can tell it to go do something and help.
Do you want to tie me to it, and then I'll go out, and then you'll pull me back? Okay, so I tie my waist to the rope of climbing. I go, and he tells it to push.
All right, so you can get to the rope. So you bring the rope. And then
take it from Spitz.
Yeah, and Spitz goes, because they're gonna send something up to get you down.
There's a rope here now that reaches the ground.
So there's basically 900 feet of ropes.
Yes.
I hope Spitz tells them what to just pull.
I'm gonna tie it off.
Inconceivable.
Can we just climb
Spitz goes
down?
They
it?
Said they're gonna send you something up. Are you gonna climb down? He goes. Spitz looks out and he goes, "You gonna climb down this?" 900 feet?
I start pulling.
Okay.
Bringing it up. I'm going to do it when I'm at the end of the 60 feet while I'm out there.
So you pull it up, and on the ends are these two...
Paragliders. Little ones.
Yes.
Summon back my...
I understand them.
Let's do a... So what do you got? You got craft?
So, leave it with them.
Don't have craft, but I'm imagining that investigation...
Yep.
But I do have an ability for
your gnome. You should have a some sort of
a. I have a gnome. Where'd it go?
You have a gnome something.
Here we are, right here.
The gnome.
So, Artificer's Lore. Add twice your proficiency bonus to history checks related to magic items, alchemical objects, or technological.
Yes, this is the latter.
So, plus 14.
Yes.
Oof.
They're stuck in the bowl.
16. So 30. Or is that cocked?
That's fine. 30. Yeah, okay, so yeah, you pretty much get how these things work. The problem here is there's two problems.
One is
they're made for gnomes. So
I don't see that necessarily as a problem.
It's not a problem for you. So they don't probably carry, wouldn't be quite as good. Second problem is it's windy. So two issues there. You think you could probably figure out how to use it. If it'd been a nice, you know, if it was a nice, breezeless day, you know, it'd be probably pretty easy for you to just glide on down using the little pulleys and going to the side. But in the wind, it's going to be a little challenging for you. It's going to be even more so for two humans that try to use them. So there's that issue.
YOLO. These will work great.
Cool.
No, I'll share my concerns. But we have the ropes here as well.
Can you shrink?
Me?
No.
No. Anybody. Can you shrink? Can you shrink?
I don't think so.
Can you make yourself lighter?
I'm not up there anymore.
Do you have a...
Mm-mm.
No.
We could. Reduce.
Could. Here we go.
Jump into the box of holding.
Wow.
Because there's only a little bit of air.
You have a box of holding?
Going into a box
of holding. Yeah, we have a box of holding. Archibald's carrying it, actually. So I'm willing to jump into the box of holding that you can carry.
How long of an air supply?
Yeah.
We're going to go probably 5 minutes, right? Yeah, 5 minutes.
That doesn't seem like nearly.
You think there's air in a box of holding for 5 minutes? Do a knowledge arcana roll.
Six.
I'll do an artificer.
Cass is gonna die in this.
Yeah, I'm gonna die in this.
19.
You're pretty much sure there's no air in a box of holding or a bag of holding.
Well, that was my thought.
Yep.
What if you can't? Spitz goes, what if you don't have to breathe?
As what do you mean?
Well, what if you were like
feigning death,
comatose, or
you still have to breathe while you're comatose?
That's so cute.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Look at the gnomes.
The gnomes with the battle hexes.
That's so cute.
And their arms are behind them. That's the best part.
That's great. You know. Or what if you were turned you into something else? Like someone turned you into something else.
You have to assist us per contract, so.
Are you proposing to turn them into something else?
Sure.
Can you give some more details than just?
If they don't resist, I can turn them into something.
Rutabagas?
Can you turn me into a gnome?
No.
I
can't turn you into a gnome.
That's a very powerful spell.
Right? Imagine all of us as gnomes running around.
Not necessarily liking that idea, but it's a very powerful
spell. I could turn you into a spider.
Ooh.
Oh, all right.
For a period of time.
All right.
Or a bat.
Ooh, why don't you turn me into a bat?
Why didn't you mention that earlier?
I'm
not dumb.
I will take the bat.
Okay. So, Charlotte was saying it, but I was thinking. Sorry, Clary. I blame you. Why couldn't you have turned us all into bats?
Well, nobody asked me.
This is so annoying.
Fritz, would you turn me into a bat?
Who's Fritz?
His second cousin. We don't talk about Fritz.
Is his Taylor brother.
Yeah, but Fritz.
But you want me to turn you into a bat? But then what are you going to do? Oh, you're going to fly down.
Yes.
In the wind, as a bat.
What if they were to get turned into bats and then I put them sort of somewhere in my pockets or something, someplace comfortable.
Right.
Where you stay warm.
Yeah. Because it's cold and you're starting to freeze.
Don't get too wingy or clingy. But then I would, hang glide down.
How long is this going to last, Bits?
A little while. Not very long.
Like more than 5 minutes?
Than 5 minutes.
Based on my understanding of the distance to go, the wind, and I basically start doing sort of like a technical evaluation. How long do I think it'll take me to get down? Roll.
Roll.
10, 24.
I mean, the wind and things, you're going to probably go further, you might be able to bank in. It's gonna probably take you about six minutes to get down.
How long?
7 minutes.
How long
is it? A long time. Spell that.
10 minutes.
Oh, we can do it. Okay. I think we can do it.
Please summon back my holy symbol, so that I could use magical spells if we need to. If we fell,
I turn and I go. I go. Nobody's like. Make sure no.
Okay. I body block him.
I say, cast this holy symbol of Anubis.
Ding.
It Pierce. Pops out of my bag, and I'm like, what the? Oh, God. Cass is going to kill me.
Poof.
And, all right.
What?
So.
Definitely make a note on that. No, makes a note.
Bat me up, Spitz.
Bat me up. Okay.
Wait. I get the gliders ready.
Okay.
I do tie the second one back onto the rope.
Okay.
And then I tell Spitz, once we get going,
throw the rope over.
Well, try not to damage the paraglider.
Lower it.
And you got your magic rope back, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Right, you ready?
Yes.
Bat, right?
Yep.
Bad.
And I allow this magic. I
Thank you.
Concentrate on it.
Allowing this magic to work on you, huh? Yeah.
Shut up, Spitz. Huh? Concentrate. I'm not hating you.
You're not hitting me?
I have to concentrate on that.
Oh, okay.
Punchable face. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, he says, not a... He goes, right. Not a cat, not a hat. I turn you into a bat.
Love that.
And he touches you.
I'm like a bat.
Yeah, he turned to a bat. You don't resist it, right?
Nope.
He goes, not a hat, not a cat.
Tuck you away.
I turn you into a bat. He touches you. Do you resist it? Yeah, you're a little bat.
I tuck you away.
Tuck you away. All right.
Sure. How do I write that one down? That's a good one.
Not a hat, not a cat.
Yeah.
I turn you into a bat. That spits his bat spell. Okay.
Now I know.
So
you can cast it.
So I should be able to push off to a degree if there's wind.
Right. So, all right. So you do, and now you need to make
some rolls.
You need to make some rolls. I'm gonna have you.
Just the bottom like this.
I am going to assume, based on your initial roll of the item, that you know how to use the item. So
now you're back.
You need to make reflex saves.
Reflex saves.
Yeah. So
that's good.
Not free reflex. They're dex saves. Sorry, they're called.
Dex saves.
Reflex saves are in 3.5. We're not playing 3.5. We're playing 5.0. So
in 5.0, a dex save is just basically...
It's what's the reflex save is in 3.5.
So it's a roll plus my dex bonus.
And your proficiency bonus.
And my proficiency
bonus. If you are proficient in dexterity saves.
Oh,
which you are.
Yes.
Which as a rogue, yeah.
Where, Archie, where are my proficiency? Where's my proficiency bonus?
It'll be +3. We all have the same. Is it +3? Yeah.
Mine's +3, if that makes sense.
It's plus three for everybody.
It's
+3. Yeah.
Okay. So, all right. So I have +7.
All right. So let's make the first roll of the initial.
I can't. You guys are too far away for me to help in any way.
11.
All right, so you go off, and as soon as you go off, you start gusting to the side, and you're like, ah! And you're kind of plummeting a little more. Make another one.
Good thing I can heal folks, if you know.
What is that total, 17?
That's it, I can jump out of
you kind of, you're still going off, kind of, but you kind of get a little right, you get a little more righted. You're kind of going down, and it's starting to, you're starting to get a little more buoyancy.
And I'm wanting to make sure that I'm keeping track of time.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
I give you bardic inspiration.
On the pure comedy level, I do not believe you can cast spells as a bat.
Yeah, it's not a spell.
It's just inaudible.
It said, yeah, if you can hear me within 60 feet, you can get my bardic inspiration.
Incredible.
It's not over until the bat sings.
The bat sings. The bat sings.
Yeah, but they chitter.
So that gives me a plus what?
If
you get a bat.
Maui can sound like a bat, by the way.
If I get a bat roll?
Yeah. Bat sound.
You can spend it before you know the results.
Okay.
You can roll that and add that to it.
All right.
All right, so what is the, is it a, gives you an advantage?
A D8 that he can use after he rolls.
He's going to need it because he's going to, okay, he rolls bad, he's going to crash and burn.
But
take
before
you both
he
can heal. Take everyone with him.
Okay, well, not everyone.
Oh, nice. 20.
Natural 20.
You pretty much get it under control.
Look at me, I'm Tom Cruise.
You learn that, and you kind of, this is where you figure out if you go closer to the cliff, you're safer because the winds won't catch you, and they're swirling out further in the lake. But
closer so I go cliff, appropriately little, closer to the
yeah,
cliff.
Yeah, and then you start going down in a little spiral thing. Let's do one more roll to see if you can land. I'm hoping you crash just because it's funny. Nope, you don't. You're going to die. Does he get a die in every time he rolls?
Nope.
No,
I
just
can choose to take it. Should I choose to take it?
Why not?
I think this is
you're
my
pretty
last
close.
Check.
Yeah, it's your last check.
You can land with panache.
Yeah, you can land like the perfect.
I land with panache. That's an 18. Am I still getting the, since it's a technical? So yeah, so it's +14. So that's 18 plus 14.
No, you get your dex. It's your
oh, yeah, yeah,
your dex save.
That plus 7. So 19, 25.
Yeah, yeah, you come down. Whoosh. One of the kids goes, nicely done.
You do the skin no a little bit.
It comes down. And just as you come down, they explode.
Okay, I was going to be like, where are they at?
The bats are out. And they go, whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, hi, everyone.
I think I lost a button.
Yeah.
Do you happen to have any warmer clothes?
Oh, I thought you were going to ask for Grey Poupon there for a second. I was pretty sure.
And some warmer clothes.
Yeah, we have warmer clothes. You don't have warmer clothes?
Well, we did.
It's been a long story, man.
We can outfit you. But right now, we should do that. And then we should probably get ready.
For?
That. And he points. And there's a horde of orcs coming across the ice towards you. And thank you for... this day, we're going to stop for the day.
Next week,
it's the horde of orcs. And you've got the gnomes. You got your gnomes and you got yourselves.
And Spitz.
And Spitz the Great.
We're not going to be back until the end of
February. We're taking Valentine's Day off. And so we'll be back at the end of February. You can see what happens. That's a big cliffhanger. Yeah, right.
At least it was a cliff baller.
Yeah. You guys do turn back because your time for your bat, your bat
stuff. How'd you like being a bat?
So, yeah, how did you like being a bat?
I land, I take my hat off, I sort of shake my hair out, I say, hello, gentlemen.
Pretty awesome.
All right.
Wait, where's Spitz?
We're going to leave that till next time. Where's Spitz? Thank you for joining us. Everyone have a very nice weekend, and we'll see you in what? End of February?
Yeah.
End of February.
We should level up before then, right?
For sure.
When did you level up last?
Like
a while ago.
What level are you?
Seven. We're seven.
No, are you seven?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ready?
Pre-level to make sure.
Seven. We are seven. We should be eight by now.
Why?
We should be eight.
Tell me why you should be eight.
Because it's been too long since we leveled up.
We fought the wizard who stole Christmas.
For sheer laughs alone.
Didn't you level up once you fought the wizard? Mm-mm. Are you sure?
Yep.
Are you lying to me?
No, we didn't.
No, I'm not.
Oh, you didn't level up after the wizard?
No, we've been seven for quite a long time. Yeah, and that's why I keep on saying
that. What do you guys think at home? Should they level up?
Right before a giant orc fight?
Steve, don't you think that we should be like level eight right now?
Everybody make a nice hat.
No, Steve's going like, nah.
Steve be like, level six.
They're not going to get involved, are they? Okay. We'll give you a level up.
Yay for Christmas miracles! I love that campaign. I played twice and I got a level.
It was deserved.
I asked Maui and Maui started wagging her tail.
Yay, good job, Maui!
But if we went on Maui's sheet, you would always go up.
Steve says the XPs say so.
The XPs say so. Yeah.
Yay!
He has spoken.
He has spoken. All right. Nice. All right. Well, thank you all and have a great weekend and we'll see you in a few weeks.
A fortnight or two.
Fortnight, yeah, or two.
Ooh, fortnight.